Psoriasis is an extremely prevalent disorder affecting approximately 2% of the general population, and it's characterized by disorders of both the epidermis as well as the immune system. Despite the prevalence of this disease, the pathogenesis is incompletely understood. It's known that the immune system plays an important role, and the discovery of the IL-17-IL-23 axis has led to the development of new biologic therapies that have revolutionized psoriasis treatment. However, psoriasis is a lifelong disorder, and as such, lifelong immunosuppression does pose the potential for certain complications such as infections or neoplasias. So towards the end of developing a therapy with less toxicity, we focused on the role of the epidermis in psoriasis. There are two well-known epidermal triggers that exacerbate this disease. One is called wound healing. It's also known as the Kebner phenomena. And this is well known to cause the activation of a small GTPase termed RAC1 in the leading edges of the epidermis during the wounding process. And it has been known that group A strep, upon binding to the CD44 receptor of keratinocytes, does also activate the small GTPase RAC1. So with this evidence in mind, we undertook a more concerted study of the role of RAC1 activation in human psoriasis. We found that RAC1 was consistently hyperactivated in a large panel of psoriatic epidermis from human psoriasis patient biopsies. Looking further at human primary psoriasis keratinocytes, we found a persistent hyperactivation of RAC1 under normal culture conditions, as well as after challenge with a number of different cytokines, including TNF-alpha, as well as several other cytokines known to be involved in the pathogenesis of human psoriasis. With this in mind, we designed a transgenic mouse model where an activated mutant of RAC1 termed V12-RAC1 was driven by a keratin-14 epidermal-specific promoter. At 7 days, we saw a very profound scaling and erythematous skin phenotype closely resembled human psoriasis, which progressed over several weeks, involving both the skin as well as the joints. The skin histologically showed very profound psoriatic hyperplasia, as well as inflammation, hypogranulosis, perikeratosis, and many other hallmarks of psoriasis. In these skin samples of the transgenic mouse, we saw significant epidermal proliferation, as well as infiltration of immune cells, particularly T cells, as well as dendritic cells. We crossed these RAC1 mice with an immunodeficient non-SCID mouse that lacked T cells. And following the cross, we saw a complete resolution of the phenotype. We demonstrated RAC1 was hyperactive in the epidermis. However, without T cells, there was no progression of disease. These results in total suggested then that the disease in our mice was driven by an epidermal defect, but it required the participation of an intact normal immune system to drive the disease pathogenesis.
After characterizing the mouse model, we went ahead and elucidated the overlap between the RAC1 mouse skin and human psoriatic skin. We found a significant overlap in several signaling proteins, chemokines, and cytokines that are known to be upregulated in human psoriatic skin. Further, looking at the transcriptional overlap between the RAC1 mouse skin and human psoriasis skin, we found several signaling pathways that were shared and activated in both our mouse model as well as human psoriatic skin. Further, we validated that these signaling cascades are amenable to modulation through either upregulating RAC1 or inhibiting active RAC1 in primary human keratinocytes. To assess the relevance of this in an in vivo system, we then went ahead and isolated patient cells, both keratinocytes and fibroblasts from the skin, as well as autologous PBMCs from the blood of psoriasis patients or normal controls. We next engineered the organotypic 3D skin equivalents that we grafted to immunodeficient mice and injected these grafts with autologous PBMCs. By selectively engineer the keratinocytes by either overexpressing a control or a dominant negative mutant of RAC1, we were able to demonstrate that functionally active RAC1 is necessary to drive the psoriform hyperplasia we managed to get from injecting PBMCs into these xenografts.
Our results in total suggest that RAC1 is playing a very important role in driving the communication between the epidermis and the immune system. RAC1 is promoting pathways involving differentiation, proliferation, cytokine production. And the cytokines are in turn feeding back into the immune system to both chemoattract as well as differentiate the cells. And at the same time, RAC1 is promoting hyperactivation of the epidermis to the signals in the immune system that it's playing a hand in creating, thereby driving a very vigorous positive feedback loop. In addition, our findings put together a model that both incorporates environmental triggers such as wound healing and group A strep infection, as well as genetic susceptibility genes together to be able to provide a model that portrays the pathogenesis of this complex genetic skin disease.